Josiah here at easycaters.com, and today I'm going to go over the settings of the latest version of the AutoFibs indicator, the AutoFibonacci levels, retracements, and extensions study that we provide for ThinkOrSwim. And so let's just dive right into it. So you can see here I've already got the indicator added to the screen. We can right-click and bring up Edit Study to go into the settings. And since I did the original video, the walkthrough video for this indicator, we've added a lot of different settings, a lot of different options that you can use to customize or hone in your analysis. So the original version, we had the built-in period setting, which allows you to plot levels for any of the built-in periods that come with ThinkOrSwim. As you can see here, there's a selector for you to choose the built-in period. You can choose the yearly levels. So if you can see here, here's the high and low of the year, and we've got the retracements for that. You can change it to quarterly levels or monthly or weekly or whatever you like. And so it shows the quarterly levels here. Additionally, you can scroll it back in time. So you could plot last year's levels on this year, or you can plot last quarter's levels. So if I put it one period back, you can plot last quarter's levels on this quarter's price action. So you can see it takes the high of last quarter here, the low of last quarter here, and plots it forward on the current quarter's price action. And so then it's taking, in the future here, it'll be taking the high of the current quarter, the low of the current quarter down here, and plotting that in the future price action. So that's how that works. So you can scroll this any number of periods back in time that you want, any of that you have loaded on the chart, and you can use it for any of these built-in periods. So you can see here weekly levels, which should have 5 daily bars per week. You can see that here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again, you can scroll that back or forward to any number of periods that you want. And you can view this, you know, say on a 30-minute chart instead. So you've got weekly levels on a 30-minute chart. I'll switch back here to daily, and then we'll look at some of these other settings. So built-in period, that's the setting that you see here. And let me just set that to monthly. So you can see here's the monthly levels being plotted. Now we'll switch to day, including, actually, we'll go ahead and look at some of these other first. So manual prices allows you to set your own high and low for the range in a manual way. So if you see here, maybe I could choose 180 as the high and maybe 140 as the low. And so you just go down here to manual price high, manual price low, 180, 140, and you can see that it chooses those prices and shows you the retracements between those two levels. So you can manually control the levels that way. You can also choose, if you notice it switched the presentation a little bit from the repeating periods to a single period plotted all the way across the screen, a certain number of bars. And you can choose that number of bars here. You can also choose full chart width. So it'll just go all the way across the chart, all the way back in time. And so you can see that here. And then if we go back in here into settings, see manual dates. So we can actually, instead of choosing levels, we can choose two dates that we want to evaluate as the beginning and the end. And so I'll put the end date as today, 2022, and 09/26. And maybe we can just put the beginning of the year, 2022, 01/01. And so now it will grab the high and the low of the year. You can see here the high and the low of the year and plot those for you as well. But that would be the same if I had chosen, say, 3/30 as the starting date. Let me just do that, 2022/03/30. And so it chooses this as the high instead of that period. And this is still the low, but you can see that it skipped the high of the year that happened on the first 2 days of the year here. So that's how the manual dates works. It just finds the high and the low between two different dates that you choose. So those are new settings in the updated version. Okay, so we can set this to rolling periods, and down here in the rolling period setting, you can choose how many periods to evaluate. So if we choose 100 periods, then it will look at the last 100 bars. As it is, it's going to look at 100 days. And so then it's going to find the low of that and the high of that, which it looks like is this. So let's see if we can choose something a little larger and see how that works. Let's set it to 500. So now we'll look at the last 500 bars. And so now the low has become this point of the last 500 bars, and this is the high. And so that's how it's drawing the levels at this point. So that is the rolling period setting. You can choose any number of periods that you want. Full chart, you can look at the high and low of the whole data set that you have loaded on your chart. So this would be that. And then we have got the intraday setting. So let's switch to an intraday chart. And so here I am on a 30-minute chart, and let me pull back up the settings. And so we will look at, let me just do specific length, and I will set this to the day, including extended hours. And it'll probably help if I add the rollover lines to show rollover lines. So you can see where each day begins and ends. Let me switch to a smaller time frame chart here. So now you can see we've got day including extended hours, but we don't have extended hours showing on the chart, so it doesn't have the ability to await that until we add those that data to the chart with it. So I'm going to turn on show extended hours trading session. And so now it will take, instead of the low down here at the regular hours, it's taking the low from down here during the extended hours. And because I have it truncated to only show the last 100 bars, it's stopping the lines here, but you can just as easily extend them further. Or we can even switch to repeating period, where it switches the presentation style a little bit to show you the developing high and low as it develops in real time, instead of just a flat line all the way across the screen. So that's day including extended hours. You can do day excluding extended hours. This is useful for, in ThinkOrSwim, the makers of the software actually evaluate futures and stocks a little bit differently. So with futures, extended hours can be considered part of the normal daily trading bar. And so it's hard to exclude the extended hours when you're looking at a futures chart. So this setting for excluding extended hours is mostly useful in futures charts, where you want to specifically exclude the extended hour sessions. In stock trading charts, the extended hours are automatically excluded if you put it on built-in period and set it to day. You can see here this should do the same levels. You can see there. But if we were to put this on a futures chart, then it would look at all of this action and use that as the day. So if you wanted to exclude that extra price action outside of the regular hours, then you can switch to day excluding extended hours. The next setting would be opening range. And for that, you need to choose an opening range start time and an opening range end time. So I've got it set to 9:30 and 10. So it's a 30-minute period. And so you can see what that looks like here. And so it looks at the first 30-minute bar. That's the high, that's the low, and then it plots that for the rest of the day. You can also change this to specific length so that the lines are easier to look at that way. And of course, all these levels and plots are, you can customize them in any way you want. Down here in the plots section here, all the plots listed. You can click each one. You can turn off individual plots here if you don't want a specific level showing on your chart. You can hide the bubbles over here on the price axis. You can change the line style, dash, dots, squares, angles, whatever you like, the thickness of the line, and the color of the line here. So you can individually control every line here on the indicator. So back up here, so we're looking at opening range mode, and we've got it set to specific length. The only other thing about this is you need to know that you can also show extensions, not just retracement levels. So you can control that here. Now we've added some additional levels that you can show. The way that this works is it takes the initial retracement range here and clones it above and below, either one, whichever one you want, or both, and it allows you to plot so that like your 236 level would become 123.6 and 223.6 and 323.6. So it automatically the range is cloned above that, and whatever levels you choose here turn into those, you know, additional, you know, you just add 100% for each new extension level that you add. So here I've got upper extensions enabled, and so I'll hit apply and show that. And so you can see that the 23.6 became 123.6, like I was saying, and same with all the other levels. And so it just cloned this whole range and put it directly on top. And again, if you don't want to look at all these levels here, you can go back into the settings and turn off the individual plots for those lines down here in the plots subpanel. And so you can just choose the upper extensions that you want to turn off and turn that off. And then if you want to show two levels of extension, so we can do up to five levels of extensions above and five levels below. So we go to 200 here, then 300, 400, 500, so forth. So you can turn off or turn these on, and let me just squeeze the scaling down a little bit here so you can see that. So we've got the initial levels here, first extension, and the second extension levels. And you can see here that 23.6 became 123.6, but it also became 223.6. So whatever you choose in that Retracement range is what gets cloned above or below. And so we can do the same thing with lower extensions. We'll turn on lower extensions one and see that. You can see we've got extensions to the downside down here. And so that's how the indicator works. And you can do five of those extension levels on either side, both above and below. And so you can go up to the 500% level. So some of these other settings here, you can turn on or off the individual levels for the original retracement range. You can turn off the levels for the individual extension ranges here. And so you got levels for each of those. And again, you can control the plot styles all individually here. We've got alerts that you can trigger for any of the first two levels, the original retracement range, then the first extension and the first extension here. And then we've got just a global setting for the cloud that you can show behind the retracement levels here if you like. You can turn that to any color you want. You can also turn it all the way off up here at show clouds. You can also reverse the direction that the indicator shows. So you can see here 0% is at the high now and 100% is the low. So just switching this one setting allows you to visualize it in a different way. Some people prefer it one way and some people prefer it the other. You can also show on the repeating period setting, you can show last period. And so that would allow you to only show the current day, current week, or whatever you like. Let me change this to built-in period, show you how that works. So this is showing the current day's price action level. You can set it to show, to not only show the last period, and then it should show us here all the periods in the past that are loaded on the chart. So you can see that here. Okay, and the last setting that I wanted to go over today is the new zigzags functionality. So in past versions, we've always had the zigzag functionality where you could look at the most recent fully completed swing and plot levels based on that range. So in the latest version, we've expanded that to where you can derive the levels from, or the range from any of the previous five swings, including the current swing. So that would be, the current swing would be this, one swing ago, two swings ago, three, four, five. So that's as far back as you can go to derive your levels. But in addition to that, we've also added the ability to project those levels from a different range than it's drawn from, or a different zigzag swing than it's drawn from. So you can independently set the point at which the levels are projected with this setting here. So I'll show you how that works. So currently we're looking four swings ago. So that's current swing is one, or is this one here, one, two, three, four. And so four swings ago is this range, and we're taking that range and we're plotting it from three swings ago, it looks like. And plotting from means we're looking at, we have the current swing, which is the current point right here, one, two, three. And so you can see we're anchored to the bottom of that swing. And so you could look at this in terms of we've made this move this way, we've retraced back about 50%, and now you could expect movement in the direction of the original move toward this 100% level to complete a symmetrical move there. So you have, you know, this will be your A, B, C, or however you look at that. So that's kind of a unique ability that we've added in this version of Auto Fibonacci. And as far as a couple of other examples of how you could use this, we could look at anchoring this move, this range, to this retracement point here. So we got one, two, three, the third swing back in time, and we're gonna anchor to the zero, one, two, the second point back in time. And so we'll see what that looks like here. And so you can see here, what we're showing is we've made this move here, we retraced it, and now we're looking for a symmetrical move back in the same direction. So this retracement here might fail and come back down, or we'll, you know, see what happens, but this could be the expectation. And this functionality basically mimics the built-in Fibonacci extensions drawing tool. So if you can see here, I'll use that. It's a three-point tool. Click three times, and I have some of the levels turned off here, but let me turn those back on real quick. And you can see that it matches up. We've got, oh, and I've got the indicator set to show 100 at the highs. So if we reverse that, you can see what that looks like here. And so now we've got the retracement levels all matching up here, and you can see that the functionality of the drawing tool is mimicked in the AutoFibs, only it's done automatically for you, grabbing the levels from this range and then plotting the levels, projecting them from another range. So that's the functionality in the new AutoFibs. I just wanted to walk you through how that works. You can now use, like I said, any of the past five swings as your range and any of the past five swing points as your projection point. You can, of course, use the same way that you've always used it, which, you know, draw the range from the most recent fully completed swing and project it from the same place. And you can, you know, of course, use your extension levels from that range and everything as usual. We can go in here and turn on the extensions and see how that works. And so this is an example of taking this particular last completed swing and then projecting that range above and projecting it below. And I'm on a logarithmic scaling, so you can see it's expanded. But if you turn it back to the absolute mode here, you can see what it looks like in, on a normal chart setting. So I've got this range here, and we've extended it above and extended it below. And so you can see all the extension levels in that way. So you can still use it in that same form, or you can use it as a symmetrical fib extensions drawing tool type of replacement to automatically draw those same levels for you instead of having to manually go down here and draw them yourself. So pretty excited about that new setting, new capabilities in the indicator. Just wanted to go over those settings, and hopefully you guys will enjoy that and get some use out of it. If you have any questions, as always, feel free to email us on the website at easycaters.com/contact. Leave us a comment below. And please, if these videos help, hit subscribe and like, and that always helps us out. And we appreciate it. And I will talk to you next time.